लास्ट लेक्चर वी सॉ ए शॉटकी जंक्शन बिटवीन ए मेटल एंड ए एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर एंड बाय इट्स आईवी करेक्टरिस्टिक्स दैट लुक लाइक आईवी करेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ ए पीएन डायोड वी कैन कॉल ए शॉटकी जंक्शन एज ए शॉटकी डायोड. So therefore, we can use a Schottky junction as a diode. And in next lecture, we will see some major differences between a PN diode and a Schottky diode. And in last lecture, we mainly made a Schottky junction between a metal and a N-type semiconductor, but we can also make a Schottky junction between a metal and a p-type semiconductor. So if the work function of p-type semiconductor is higher than the work function of the metal, then this junction can also show a IV characteristic of a diode or a Schottky diode. So this junction is also known as a Schottky junction. So if we make energy band diagrams for this junction, so first let me draw the band diagram for metal. We know that this is the vacuum level and this is the Fermi level for the metal, and here we are taking a p-type semiconductor that has a work function higher than the work function of the metal. So this is the vacuum level for the semiconductor. This is EC. This is Fermi level for the p-type semiconductor, and this is EV. So here we can see that since the Fermi level in the semiconductor is lower than the Fermi level of the metal, so to achieve Fermi level equilibrium at the junction, electrons now will move to the semiconductor side. So in this way, here we got a positive charge and here we get a negative charge. So in this way, there is a contact potential between these two junctions, and due to some movement of the electrons in this side that has a majority carrier, holds as majority carriers, so there is a depletion region in the p-type semiconductor. So this is before and after. Since electrons are going into the p-type semiconductor, so here the Fermi level will go in upward direction. So after making a junction, there Fermi levels will line up. So after making a junction, there is a depletion region into the p-type semiconductor only. So this is vacuum level, this is EC, and this is EV. So here, since a p-type semiconductor has holes as majority carriers, so here instead of barrier height for electrons. Here we look a barrier height or a barrier for holes. So here we have to calculate this barrier height. And this barrier height can be written as phi b prime, which is equal to the electron affinity of the semiconductor plus band gap of the semiconductor minus work function of the metal. And we know that this is the electron affinity and this is the work function of the E-type semiconductor and this is the EG, that is band gap of the semiconductor. So if we apply a forward bias to this junction, that is positive terminal, if we give positive terminal to the P-type semiconductor and negative terminal to the metal, then we get a sufficient amount of current. And when we apply a reverse bias, then there is very little amount of current. So in this way, this junction also behaves as a rectifying device or a Schottky diode. And it's important to note that first let me write about this barrier height. Since the current in a P-type semiconductor is carried by holes, now we have to look for barrier for holes in the Venn diagram. And this is the barrier for holes, which is given by this equation. Here EG is the band gap of the semiconductor and we know that JS is the electron affinity. So in this way we can calculate the barrier for holes. And it's important to note that Schottky barrier on P-type semiconductor in general have smaller barrier height and are rarely used in practical devices. So for practical devices, we only concerned about the Schottky barrier between a metal and a N-type semiconductor. Since for making a device based on a Schottky diode, a sufficient height of barrier is necessary. So in most of the cases, devices that depends upon the Schottky diodes, we use a Schottky diode between a metal and a N-type semiconductor. So this is all about the Schottky diode. Now we can look a junction between metal and a semiconductor that can be show a linear characteristic between current and voltage, or a short or a ohmic junction. So now let's look a ohmic junction between a metal and a semiconductor. So as I said earlier, if the work function of metal and semiconductor are in such a way that semiconductor can get more charge carriers as majority carriers, then there is a ohmic junction between a metal and a semiconductor. That is, if we take a metal in such a way that its work function is lower than the work function of the N-type semiconductor, then this junction is known as ohmic junction. And if we take a P-type semiconductor, then we have to reverse this condition. So if we take the energy band diagrams for this junction, let me first draw energy band diagram for metal. So this is vacuum level, this is Fermi level for metal, and again here I am taking a N-type semiconductor. So this is the vacuum level of the semiconductor. This is the conduction band for the semiconductor. This is the valence band. Since this is a N-type semiconductor, so this is the Fermi level for. So this is EC and this is EV. And here we can see that the Fermi level in the metal side has a higher position. So now electrons will move from metal to semiconductor. So in this way, now the Fermi level of the semiconductor side will move in upward direction. So this is before. So let me draw the band diagrams after making the junction. So here again this is E vacuum, and so now let me try it near to this. So now same conductor will get negative charges and metal gets positive charges. So here we can say that now a n-type semiconductor are getting more electrons. So here at the surface there is an increase in the conductivity of this metal side. So this junction behaves as a Ohmic junction, since here there is a very small height, barrier height for the electrons. If electrons wants to move from metal to semiconductor, and at the same time there is no built-in potential if electrons want to move from semiconductor to metal side. So this junction behaves as a Ohmic contact that has a linear current voltage characteristic. So this is a Ohmic junction. Here this is metal and this is n-type semiconductor, and this is vacuum level, this is EC and this is EV. So let me write few lines here. So since the Fermi level in the metal side is higher than the Fermi level in the semiconductor side, at equilibrium electrons will move from the metal to the empty states in the conduction band. Of the semiconductor, so that there is an accumulation region near the interface the accumulation region has a higher conductivity than the bulk of the semiconductor. Due to the higher concentration of electrons, thus a ohmic contact or a ohmic junction behaves as a resistor conducting in both forward and reverse bias. So a ohmic junction between a metal and a semiconductor can behave as a resistor. So here we can see that when we apply a forward bias, that is when we apply a, this is metal side and this is semiconductor side. So when we apply a forward bias, that is negative terminal to this side and positive terminal to this side, that is negative to the n-type semiconductor and positive to the metal, then fermi level of the semiconductor will go in upward direction. So in this way electrons can easily, more easily move, can move from this semiconductor to metal side. So we get a sufficient amount of current. And when we apply a reverse bias, that is when we connect this n-type semiconductor to negative terminal of the battery, and when we connect a positive terminal of the battery to the metal side, after this connection, now the Fermi level in the semiconductor will go in downward direction. So after that we can see a bending like this in downward direction. So there are plenty of electrons in the metal. So now electrons from the metal side can easily move to the semiconductor. So in this situation also we get a sufficient amount of current. In forward bias we get current due to electrons that are coming from the semiconductor side to the metal side, and in reverse bias condition we get a sufficient amount of current due to the movement, due to the easily movements of the electrons from the metal to the semiconductor side. So in this way, we can get a sufficient amount of current in forward bias and reverse bias condition. So such type of junction between a metal and a semiconductor is known as Ohmic junction or Ohmic contacts. And this Ohmic contact between a metal and a semiconductor is very essential in electronic industry, because for connecting an electronic device due to the external world, we have to use a Ohmic contact between that device and the external part of our world. That is, we have to give some bias, or we have to collect the sufficient current from the device. So this is all about the metal semiconductor junction. First, we discussed about a Schottky junction between a metal and a semiconductor. So when we use a metal with higher work function than a n-type semiconductor, then we get a Schottky junction that can be used as a Schottky diode. And when we use a metal with lower work function than the n-type semiconductor, then we get a Ohmic contact. Here, for example, silicon and aluminium. Silicon and aluminium can make a Ohmic contact. And at the same time, if we use a silicon and gold AU that has a higher work function than the silicon, then so this is a Ohmic junction. But if we take a example of silicon and gold, then this junction is a Schottky junction. This is Ohmic junction and this is Schottky junction. So this is all about Ohmic and Schottky junction. And in next lecture, we will see some major differences between a PN diode and a Schottky diode, because a metal semiconductor junction, that is a Schottky junction, can be used as a active device in the electronic industry, and it has many applications. Here, Ohmic contact also has some application in Peltier effect, but we will not discuss that part here. So that's all about Ohmic and Schottky junction.